So the next topic in this unit is magnetic properties of solids. Now before we study the magnetic behavior of solids, I just want to take you back to something you have already done in class 11th, right? Now this is an electron. Electron is a charged body, and this charged body is never at rest. It's constantly moving in its orbital around the nucleus, and also it is moving around its own axis. Now because of this, since it's a charged body and constantly moving, it has an orbital magnetic moment of its own because of this orbital motion, and a spin magnetic moment of this because of this spin motion. Thus we can say that an electron itself behaves as a small magnet. So the magnetic properties jo bhi solids ki hai ya kisi bhi cheez ki hongi, that is because an electron, which is an essential part of an atom, in itself is an electron. We have these arrows representing the orbital magnetic moment and spin magnetic moment because magnetic moment is a vector quantity. It has magnitude as well as direction. So we can give a specific direction to orbital magnetic moment and spin magnetic moment. So when you study these magnetic properties, you will remember that an electron behaves as a tiny magnet. Moving to the next slide. Now we start the types of solids and the basis of their behavior in external magnetic field. How solids behave in the presence of an external magnetic field, on the basis of that, we kind of classify these solids into various categories. We have diamagnetic here, paramagnetic here, and next we have ferromagnetic. After that, we'll study antiferromagnetic and ferrimagnetic substances. What is a diamagnetic substance? These are those solids, those substances, which when placed in the external magnetic field, they experience repulsion. They are weakly repelled by external magnetic field. Why? Because they have fully filled orbitals. I've taken a diagram just to explain what happens here. This is a simple diagram jisme orbitals completely filled hai. Orbital can occupy two electrons aur sare hi orbitals completely filled hai yahan pe. You already know an electron is a magnet in itself. It has a magnetic moment of its own. But since the orbital is completely filled, wahan pe do electrons hai and they have opposite spin. Opposite spin. Magnetic moment of this is cancelled by an equal and opposite magnetic moment of another electron. Since all of these orbitals are completely filled, in these substances there is zero net magnetic moment. Right? So magnetic moment possessed by one electron is cancelled by other. Since the net magnetic moment is zero, that is why they are repelled by the external magnetic field. Now the examples are given there. We have an oxide of titanium, water, NaCl. Second type is paramagnetic substances. These substances are attracted by the external magnetic field. Jaise hi aap isko rakhoge in the presence of external magnetic field, they observe, they experience a force of attraction. Reason, they can be atoms, they can be ions, they can be molecules, it depends on the nature of the solid. What is the reason? These substances experience this force of attraction because they have unpaired electrons. Look at this diagram. This unpaired electron has a magnetic moment of its own, and there is no other electron to cancel that out. So there is a net magnetic moment to these substances. Kitna hoga net magnetic moment? We can calculate it depending on the number of unpaired electrons. Jab hum configuration likhenge, phir electrons ko orbitals mein distribute karenge, we can see how many unpaired electrons are there. I've highlighted one important point here, that is that these substances lose magnetism in the absence of magnetic field. Jaise hi aapne external magnetic field hata diya, they no longer show paramagnetism. They are magnetic only in the presence of that external magnetic field. Examples are there, molecule of oxygen, we have an ion of copper, we have an ion of iron, cupric and ferric ions. The third type is the ferromagnetic substances. Now I have highlighted a few points in this. Why? Let's see. They show permanent magnetism. Once magnetized, once aapne isko external magnetic field mein rakha and it gets magnetized, uske baad when you remove that external magnetic field, they remain magnetized, right? Now they remain permanently magnetized even in the absence of magnetic field. Now what happens is this. This is a solid, right? One arrow represents one metal ion. Okay? One arrow represents one metal ion. And a number of metal ions are grouped together. And this group of metal ions is called as a domain. Now what happens, ye jo diagram hai, it is in the absence, right in the beginning. Abhi humne external magnetic field apply nahi kiya. These domains are randomly aligned. Koi specific direction nahi hai. Once you place this solid, this substance in the external magnetic field, they get oriented in the direction of the magnetic field. And this ordering of these domains is permanent, which means ab aap remove karoge external magnetic field, but they will remain oriented in this direction. That is how they are permanent magnets. Examples are given there, right? Next kind of solids, antiferromagnetic substances. These are the substances jinka jab hum electrons ki configuration dekhte hain, we expect that they'll possess some paramagnetism or some ferromagnetism. But what happens is that they have zero net magnetic moment. Which substances fall under this category? Substances which seemingly, it seems like they might have some paramagnetism or ferromagnetism, but actually possess zero net magnetic moment. What happened there? This happened. This was the orientation when there was no magnetic field. And when you apply the magnetic field, they do get aligned. But how do they get aligned? Equal number of domains in opposite direction. One arrow represents one domain. There are these domains aligned in specific directions and they are opposite to each other, so that the magnetic moment created by this domain is cancelled by equal and opposite magnetic moment of this domain, as a result of which they have zero net magnetic moment. I've written it. This happens due to the presence of equal number of domains, but they are in opposite directions. This is an example. The last kind of the solids in this presentation is ferrimagnetic substances. Now let's go to the diagram first. It will be easier for us to understand. Ye applied magnetic field mein alignment of domains hai. But what happens is, ye domain ka arrow bada hai, is domain ka arrow chota hai. Which means, is domain mein jitne metal ions hai, utne is domain mein nahi hai. So they do get cancelled. Magnetic moment of this domain will be cancelled by the magnetic moment of this domain, but not completely. Iska jitna magnetic moment hoga, iska usse kam hoga. So what happens? What are these solids? Substances expected to have large magnetic moment, but due to the unequal number of domains in opposite directions, they possess small net magnetic moment. It gets cancelled. What is left behind is a small magnetic moment, right? I think I have one more slide. Yes. So we know what is a paramagnetic substance, what is a ferromagnetic substance. Now what happens is that I told you ferromagnetic substance, when you apply a magnetic field, remove bhi karte hain, it still behaves as a magnet. But there's a restriction. There's a restriction of temperature. At very high temperatures, they stop acting like ferromagnetic or antiferromagnetic substances and they change into paramagnetic substances. Why? Because at this very high temperature, randomization of domains takes place. Jo humne ek align kiya tha ek hi direction mein, in the direction of magnetic field, wo fir se randomly align ho jate hain. So this temperature, which temperature? Temperature above which no ferromagnetism is observed. It's called as Curie temperature. Remember this definition, right? And finally, I have given some important examples from transition metals. Transition metals say elements kaun se act karte hain as magnets, ya unke compounds act karte hain as magnets. We have paramagnetic examples, diamagnetic, ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic. Okay?